I'm Warren, and I'm here with Chad, and today we're going to talk about the process, the cost, and everything that's involved in the removal and reinstallation of solar panels if you need to do that after you've had the solar panels installed. So welcome, Chad.
Thank you, Warren.
So why don't you give us a brief understanding of what's involved in the process of a removal and reinstallation of solar panels.
Yeah, sure. So there may be many reasons why, there's not many reasons why you'd want to remove and reinstall your panels. There's really only one main reason, typically, that you have an issue with your roof and you need repair work done on your roof. So obviously, if you have solar installed on that roof to access the shingles and make the repairs, that system needs to be removed. I think we should just primarily talk about residential kind of systems, and then, you know, kind of scales up for there for commercial. Yeah, so basically you're contacting a quality solar provider and asking them for a price to remove and reinstall your roof. If you do that with Paradise Energy, we have a team of O&M service technicians who are very experienced and skilled at doing that kind of work. You get your quote. You'd basically have to take the solar panels themselves and all the mounting hardware, anything that's attached to your shingles or other roofing materials, has to come off that roof completely. Any conduits and any wiring, any other auxiliary equipment has to come off so that the roofers could go ahead and do their jobs. The big overview is the system's removed from the roof. Everything on your walls can kind of stay where it is. And the roofing contractor comes in and does their work. And then you would reschedule with the solar company to come and reinstall that hardware on the roof, kind of the same place it was, should look the same, really no changes.
So when we go out and do a removal and reinstallation, first of all, the system gets shut down. Owners should know that they're going to be paying for electricity during that time frame from their utility. They're going to get no benefit from solar from the time we shut it down until the time we reinstall it, commission it, test it, and turn it back on. But do you often run into issues where you're removing conduit and wiring and the wiring has to be replaced upon reinstallation?
I say very rarely. Solar is a fairly new industry. Yep. Electrical equipment has been around a long time. If it was installed properly, we really see very few issues. And I actually talked with our team just to make sure I'm providing up-to-date information, and they agreed that we very rarely have major repair work done, other than, which we could talk about, you know, maybe critter damage, squirrel damage that's identified when the system's removed. But what we'll try to do is we'll try to coordinate with your roofing contractor and maybe the week of, the day before, remove that system to minimize that downtime. And then it's often about a two-week window that you could expect to be down just to provide for weather delays for your roofer. But what we understand, try to minimize if possible.
A two-week period from the time the process starts until it's turned back on. But our actual work of being on site is not 2 weeks, is it?
No. So for most all residential systems, obviously there's very large systems out there, but most residential type systems, the crew would have that system off the roof in a day or less. So one day off, the easy way to think about it is one day off, 2 days on would be a good general rule of thumb.
Yeah.
So one day before the roofers get started, once the roofers are completed, 2 days to get that system back on, the roof turned on and verified that it's functioning correctly.
Okay. So if somebody's looking to either replace their roof or repair their roof if they're having an issue, the first step in the process is for them to contact us and get a quote for the work. And then we would schedule the work, and they should anticipate that entire process from start to finish. Once they sign the quote and decide to move forward and we get on site, will take about 2 weeks.
Yeah, that's correct. I think that's a conservative number just to be kind of allow for the unknowns of weather and roofing contractor schedules, et cetera.
So let's talk about the cost, what it costs to come out and remove solar panels, ballpark figures to remove them and reinstall them. And let's cover two different scenarios. One, they're replacing the roof. So we're coming out, we remove the entire system, they replace their roof, we reinstall it, or they've got a area on their roof that might only require the removal of two or four panels, and what that would look like in terms of costs.
Yeah, sure. And the easiest way we found to convey general costing for this is just a per module price, and that's kind of an industry standard. What we found for an entire system, if we're going to come out and remove the entire system off your roof, if you want to go outside, count your modules, and get a quick budgetary estimate, around $275 would be up to $300 would be kind of like a safe range. And we would do a real quote, and I could talk to you about that quoting process if you're interested. But we would do an actual quote, and there are some factors that would affect that cost, but that is generally the target range where we end up for an entire system. That varies a little bit. Obviously, if you have two, three modules, half a dozen modules, an area of your roof that modules have to be removed so the roofer can gain access and make some minor repairs, that's going to be a per hour cost, and travel is going to be the one thing that really moves the needle. The time on site required to remove a few panels is very, very minimal. The time on site to install a few panels is very, very minimal. So it's hard for me to get the same ballpark pricing for you. It's kind of how far are you from our closest Paradise office? You're going to be playing travel. One of the ways we could try to mitigate that is coordinate with your roofer repair and have that like a one trip, same day, removal, repair, and reinstall. So have that conversation with our specialist when you call and just talk about the best way to accomplish what you're trying to accomplish.
Sure. So just to put that into context of $275 or so dollars per module, I have 16 modules on my roof. So if I were to replace the entire system, remove the entire system, put it back, I'm probably looking at between $4,000 and $6,000. On your average home, you're probably closer to $10,000 on a medium-sized system. Is that sound in the ballpark?
Yeah, it does. And, significant cost to be aware of. And I don't know in your agenda if you want to talk about our roofing, you know, our roof health recommendations, but definitely something to think about. But you're in the ballpark there, yeah.
We do. We definitely want to talk about that because, you know, obviously solar is a long-term investment. Those panels, when you buy them and install them new, you're expecting that system to last at least as long as the warranty is 25, 30 years, but in reality, probably 40 years, potentially more. And the reality is at some point, your roof is going to need to be replaced during that time frame. And it may even be at the early on when you're making that decision to invest in solar, whether or not your roof is nearing the end of their life. And so what are the typical guidelines that we give here?
Yeah, I think the easiest one I've heard and the one that makes the most sense to me is you're going to know from your solar consultant through the sales process, what's the payback? What's the point where that system has paid itself off? And in my mind, a real good rule of thumb is make sure your roof is going to last at least that long. So I don't know. Do you agree with that, Warren? That makes sense to me.
I do. Yeah. So if you have a 10-year payback, it's going to take your system 10 years to pay for itself. Your roof should have at least a 10-year life left on it or more. Really, if your roof has less than a 10-year life or less than a 5-year life, you should probably look to replace your roof before you do solar, just to give you that lengthy window of not having to go through this removal and reinstallation process in the near future.
Yeah, you'll thank yourself at a later date for sure.
Do you ever run into unknown costs when you do these? As I know we talked about that a little bit earlier on, but are there unknown costs? Are there any differences really between microinverters maybe and optimizers, string inverters that impact costs or challenges?
Little. Almost all roof-mounted systems now have something we would call microelectronics on, you know, something on the back of that module, whether it's an optimizer or a microinverter. So very, very few things like that will change. What could happen, as we mentioned, is we may lift modules and our technicians see that you've had squirrels living underneath and they love to chew PV wire. Minor repair there, and we might recommend at that point, you know, when you do this, it's a great time to install that critter guard and address any known issues. I think in the years I've been watching this, we had one system ever, just for full transparency, where modules did not perform as well when they were reinstalled as when they were taken off. We worked with that customer to come up with a win-win solution for them. Other than that one scenario, I can't really think of a time where there was significant additional unknown costs associated with an R&R. It could happen, but it's not something we see regularly.
Let's talk about warranties and how you could potentially void your warranty if you have a warranty, whether it's through us, so you have a 1010, or through another company, you have a warranty on your solar system and you need to have your panels removed. Having them removed by somebody other than the company who installed them, how that could potentially impact your warranty. What are some of the things that could go wrong that could cause that lack of production to be the same after the installation?
Yeah, and just so I'm clear, Warren, sorry, my mind was drifting back. I think I called MLPE's microelectronics or something, so I'm having a technical issue in my brain here. But we want to talk about the issues that could affect the performance of that hardware or just your ability to retain your warranty.
Maybe even if a customer decided to do the removal themselves, they shut off the inverters, they removed the panels, yeah, and they stacked them in a pile inappropriately, and they got microfracture, things like that.
Yeah. I mean, basically what you're doing is you're uninstalling a solar system and you're reinstalling a solar system. And if it takes a qualified person to install a solar system, I would say it definitely takes a qualified person to uninstall it and then reinstall it. So that may seem oversimplified, but there are national electrical code requirements around how you do electrical work. There are torque requirements on hardware. There's handling best practices for modules. They're made of glass and silicon and all kinds of products that can be damaged. So you really want a qualified, experienced, you know, I would not recommend just a willing roofer as an alternative. You really run a risk. They're just unfamiliar with the product and won't be qualified to do that work safely and correctly.
Correct. And I think, correct me if I'm wrong, there's more that goes into commissioning than just turning it on and seeing green lights.
Yeah. Yeah, we have a relationship with inverter manufacturers. We have software on our computers and our phones. We have access to monitoring portals where those verifications need to be made to make sure you're going to be pleased with your system's performance when that system's reinstalled and turned on and commissioned.
Yeah. So just to finalize that, so clearly this is not something a homeowner should do on their own, but it's probably also not something they should have the roofer do or even another experienced and qualified solar installer that didn't install the system because it may void any warranties they have.
Yeah, and if you think about this, it's really common sense in one way. Paradise provides a great warranty. We call it a 10-10-10. One of those 10s is workmanship warranty. And, you know, if you have another vendor reinstall that system, it's no longer our workmanship. And it's really hard for us to backstop someone we have no relationship, know nothing about. So I'm sure I read a lot of contracts through the years from others related to removal and reinstallations. Very common. Obviously, nobody's going to backstop and honor warranties for systems that other people modified or changed.
So that's something for customers to think about. They should most certainly call the company that installed their system to do any work on the system at any point if they want to maintain their warranties.
Or at least I would say, Warren, the other point, because we do service, our team services many people's systems. There's often language in their contract, that we can comply with and they can retain their warranties, but they're limited and there's parameters around that you should be fully aware of and make sure you understand.
Correct. And to be clear, when you sign a proposal, a contract with Paradise Energy Solutions to purchase a system that includes our 10-10-10, we have language that clearly spells out that if any work needs to be done on the system, we need to do it in order to maintain those warranties.
Yeah, and we provide a discount to our customers on our rates. So we try to be as competitive as possible, but that is true. And that's simply to make sure the quality and we're meeting all expectations that our warranties are meaningful and upheld and your system can be maintained for its entire life.
Yeah. And it's not only does it bring peace of mind, it also brings efficiency to the work. When you have somebody new who doesn't have the drawings, the layout, the understanding of the system, it's all new to them. For us, we've installed it. We know the system. We have the plans. And so we're more efficient at it. And you get a discount if you go through us and you keep your warranties in place. It's really a no-brainer. What should customers think about if they've decided they've got to the point, they reached out to us, they requested a quote, they're ready to move forward, they signed the proposal? Is there anything they should do in preparation for us coming out before we come out to actually remove the panels?
Yeah. So In the quote process, just to back up a moment, in the quoting process, there may be a couple asks of you just to make sure that quote is accurate and right. So some of the preparation you can do even in the quoting process is if you have drawings, get those drawings ready. If it's a Paradise system, we already have the drawings, no problem. We already have photos, no problem. If you don't have drawings, no problem. You know, our consultant, our team may ask you for a couple pictures from the ground. You typically don't have to go on the roof. We wouldn't ask you to do anything like that. Just a couple of basic pieces of information to make sure our quote's accurate. Once that quote's accepted, the deal's moving forward. The only thing I can think of in preparation is think about where you want those modules and those rails from the roof, that roofing hardware, to be stored on your property. That's something we don't like to transport. We don't want to handle that product more than necessary, so keeping it on site has proven to be a very successful approach. It can be in a garage. It can actually be outside on a porch. This hardware is outside all the time. So just locate a preferred storage area where it's not going to be damaged by children or vehicles. And other than that, there's not a whole lot. It's a pretty easy process.
All right. So just to recap, this is really helpful, Chad. If somebody's interested or they need to remove their system for any reason, they most certainly should use the installer that installed the system for them, obviously to maintain their warranties and to make it more cost effective and efficient for themselves. The process itself, once we come on site, could take up to 2 weeks for that process, but we're only on site for 2 to 3 days, typically on a residential project. Usually we don't find additional issues when we do these for the most part. And the cost to do so is around $275 a panel. And what can impact that really is distance from our office, how long our travel time is. So if we can minimize that in any way, we might see some cost savings there. But for your average home, you're looking in the $8,000 to $10,000 or $11,000 range for an entire system. And then in preparation, just make sure we have all the information that we need and we'll make the process as seamless as possible.
Yeah, and I think that's a great overview, Warren. The pace of these types of projects is increasing as solar matures, and we have a great team who's very familiar with this process and very efficient with providing that solution for you.
Absolutely. So if you would like to find out more information or request a quote to have your system removed and reinstalled, you can either go directly to our website, paradisesolarenergy.com, where you can find our phone number, you can call us, or you can request a quote online.